Is your child not yet speaking? Do you think your child is non-verbal? Then this video is for you. Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to give you 3 quick tips on what you can do if your child has not yet begun speaking or if you think your child is non-verbal. Okay, so the first tip when your child is non-verbal is to work on communication. What I mean by this is, speech is an outcome of communication. Speech is a result of communication. Communication just generally means that the child expresses himself by himself or herself. That is, they are not forced or they are not made to speak, but they just willingly try to express or convey something. So when you're working on communication, you will basically work on requesting, that is asking for what they want. This can be done through many ways. So when your child has not begun speaking at all, there are no words, then you would start with gestures. You would start with making your child ask like this. But if your child already has some gestures, already has some sounds, then make him or her say the sound. Say for example, wo for want, or ta for tanga, or whatever is like for de do, de or do or le lo, something like that, which is just one sound or one syllable that you can work on making your child say. So some form of tool that they will use to communicate. This tool can be speech in the form of words or syllables, and it can also be gestures. The second tip is to work on pre-linguistic skills. By pre-linguistic skills, you are working on attention, concentration, eye contact, joint attention, sitting tolerance. These are some of the main pre-linguistic skills that you have to work on. So, is your child able to sit in one place and pay attention to your face or pay attention to the activity for 2 to 3 minutes? This is a good ballpark for you to consider to know if you can start working on speech. If your child is not able to sit in a place and pay attention to an activity, then it is a cue that you have to work on some pre-linguistic skills before you start working on speech or communication. If you need to know more on how to work on pre-linguistic skills, then I have some information in this link. Click on this link and you will have 2 to 3 videos where I talk about working on attention, sitting tolerance and eye contact. So watch those videos and try some activities with your child. So the third tip is to work on comprehension. Here, we know that an expression or an output of speech happens only when there is sufficient input. That is, only when your child has good enough language comprehension are they going to start expressing themselves. So the first category of language or first category of speech that we generally teach children and that is developmentally occurring is nouns. By nouns, I mean a lot of words that the child is exposed to in his environment. So this could include water, it could include bed, toys, food, it can include furniture around the house. So these are the basic nouns. So start by working on these nouns, understanding these nouns, identifying these nouns in the environment before you can start working on expression. Once your child understands a lot of nouns, then you can work on other parts of speech like verbs and prepositions and adjectives. That is all the next level. But nouns are the basic level of understanding. So we covered 3 important things that you have to take care before you start asking your child to speak. The first thing is give them an outlet to communicate. Start making them express their wants and needs. The second thing is to work on pre-linguistic skills, which are important skills that a child needs in order to sit, pay attention and follow an activity. And the third thing is to work on language comprehension before you work on language expression. So I hope this video was helpful. Share it with family and friends if you found it helpful. See you in the next video. Bye.